Hi everyone, my name is Kendrick and welcome to Travel and Live Free. In this video, we're going to cover the topic on how to pass the drone exam in Canada so you can legally fly your drone when you are in Canada. If you love traveling, chances are at some point you want to get a drone. I personally have the Mavic Air, so this is what the Mavic Air is. Now, they did release the second Mavic Air just recently, but I don't think I need to spend the money to buy the Mavic Air 2 just because I think this is good enough, especially because it's also lighter than the Mavic Air 2. Now, with that being said, as of June 1, 2019, you cannot fly a drone in Canada if it's over 250 grams. So unless you're getting the Mavic Mini, which is a nice drone, but it doesn't shoot videos with 4K, then if you want to fly 4K drones, then you need to get a drone that weighs over 250 grams. Now, there's two different exams in Canada that you can do. There's the basic exam and the advanced exam. In the case of this video, we're gonna focus on the basic exam because that's the exam that I recently just passed and completed, and now I have my drone license to legally fly my drone in Canada. Now, with that being said, there is rules and regulations, and you definitely want to check the website to see where you can fly and where you cannot fly. In general, you cannot fly over people, and you need to be 100 feet away from people if you're looking at it from a horizontal point of view. At the same time, you can only fly your drone in uncontrolled airspace. That means you need to stay away from airports or helipads when you are flying your drone. A lot of the national parks in Canada are also places where you are not allowed to fly your drone unless you get a special permit with Parks Canada. And I think that sucks because I think if you're traveling in Canada, then the national parks is the most beautiful part of Canada and you want to fly your drone. So at some point I will look into how you can get a permit into flying your drone in those places. Now, when you take the drone exam, you do need to get 65% to pass. And I've got to say that the test is really hard. One of the biggest problems with the drone exam is that a lot of questions that they ask actually doesn't have anything to do with flying a drone. In my opinion, they made the test to filter out any idiots that can potentially ruin things for everyone and fly their drone in an unsafe and unresponsible manner. Now, the drone exam in Canada is an open book exam. And if you want to get the answers for the exam, I made a list of references that you can use when you take this exam. And I'm gonna read them out to you right now because they're quite complicated. So the first one is regulations amending the Canadian aviation regulations. The second one is knowledge requirements for pilots of remotely piloted aircraft systems, 250 grams up to and including 25 kilograms. The Canadian aviation regulations, drone safety, and also using Google to find the answer by doing a Google search. So I'm gonna provide all these links in the description below, and I would recommend having them open when you take the exam. That way, when you go to those pages, if you're using a PC, you can use Control F to do a search of the terms that you're looking for when you're looking for the answer. And if you're using a Mac, you can use Command and F. Now, before taking the exam, I also recommend that you look at the DJI forum with a thread that talks about how people pass the drone exam. And I'm gonna put that link in the description below as well. And I recommend that you read through the whole thread. It's not that long. And just get an idea on how people pass the exam. That way you're well prepared when you do this multiple choice exam. Finally, someone made a really awesome study guide on YouTube on what to expect and the kind of questions they'll ask during the exam. So I'm gonna link that YouTube study guide in the description below as well. And I would recommend watching that first before you write your exam. I personally watched that just before I wrote the exam online, and it really helped, and it helped me pass the exam. I got 77% in exam and you need 65% to pass. So I did a pretty good job. But with that being said, the test is super hard. I felt like my brain was gonna explode. I was so exhausted after that, I could barely muster enough mental energy to register my drone online right afterwards. Now, after you pass the exam, you do need to register your drone with Transport Canada, and there's a $5 fee to register your drone. The test has a $10 fee, and you can write the test every 24 hours should you fail the first time you write it. After you pass the exam, you do need to print out your drone pilot certification as well as your drone registration certification as well. And you need to take a permanent marker or a label and label your drone with your Drone Transport Canada registration number. I suggest you don't use a permanent marker because if you want to sell your drone later on, then that permanent marker will be a big problem. So a label, I think, is much better because then you can just remove the label and then you're good to go when you want to sell that drone later on in the future. Soon you can be flying this drone when you are traveling within Canada, get those awesome drone video shots and those awesome drone pictures. I personally flew a drone when I traveled to Madagascar, and since then I have not got a chance to practice flying my drone, and I'm really eager to practice flying my drone, so that's why I wrote the exam. So if you are a Canadian, you love traveling, you want to get that amazing aerial video and photos, then by all means, you do need to take the drone exam. Anyways, that's about it for this video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave your comments below. And don't forget to sign up to our Travel and Live Free newsletter, where you can get a 10-step cheat sheet on how to travel around the world. You'll also get the latest tips and strategies on how to save money on travel for Canadians, how to go on around the world adventure travel for Canadians, and how to use travel to get more freedom in your life as a Canadian. You can sign up for that newsletter in the description below. Until next time, I'll see you then.